Hello everyone, welcome back to the GATE Engineering Online Learning Classes. I am Dr. Mohan Mansal. In today's tutorial, we are going to solve the problems on the even and odd signals. So just before starting the problem, I will quickly revise what is even signal and what is odd signal. If we write x of minus t, it will be satisfying equal to the x of t. So this is the property of the even signal. This signal is even signal. If x of minus t is equal to minus of xt, this one is the odd signal that we already know. If signal is neither even nor odd signal, we can define x even signal y sum of xt and x minus t divided by 2. The even signal can be defined by this formula that we have already seen in the last tutorial. Before watching this video, first you watch that video to understand what is the property of the even and odd signal. The link is given in the description. And property of the odd signal can be computed by x of t minus x of minus t divided by 2. So this is the property of the even and odd signal. First one is that if satisfy x of minus t equal to x of t, that is the even signal. If x minus t equal to minus of x t, that is the odd signal. And if signal is neither even and odd signal, then in this case signal can be represented by sum of even and odd components. So this signal can be x t can be represented by here x of t can be represented by x of even plus x of odd. That can be represented by sum of even and odd component of the signal. So here the question given in the expression is not neither even signal nor odd signal, but it is a function of even and odd signal. That means it is sum of the even and odd signal. So in this question, we have to find out which one is the even component and which one is the odd component. This is the simplest problem that you can easily identify by visualizing it. Because you already know about that sin t is the odd signal and cos t is an even signal. How it is even and odd signal? Just look at that. If you write x of sine of minus t, we know this a property of this sine signal is minus sine t. So it is satisfying the property of xt equal to minus of xt. So this signal sine t is then odd signal. I hope it is clear to everyone. Now, if we talk about the cos t, cos of t, we will replace t by minus t and we will see what we are getting in the function. Cos minus t always cos t. So it is satisfying the property of the even signal. So we know that, but this is the simplest problem. If we get complicated problem, how do we can identify which one is the even component, which is the odd component? If you have more components, how we can identify what are the even component, what are the odd components? So we'll look at this mathematically by these expressions. We'll compute x minus t, then we'll add both of xt and x minus, then we'll divide by 2 to get the even component. Similarly, we subtract x minus t with the xt and divide by 2 to get the odd component. Let's look at that. X minus t can be represented by sine minus t plus cos minus t. Here, sine minus t will be minus of sine t. Correct? And cos minus t will be the cos t. Okay. So, x minus t is the cos t minus sine t, where xt is the sine t plus cos t. Now, we know x of even is the xt plus x minus t divided by 2 that we have already seen. For more detail about the even and odd component, you can watch my previous video that is given in the description. So x even t is the xt plus x minus t divided by 2. If we add both of them, equation number 1, if we add both of them, equation 1 and equation 2, you can see that sin t will cancel out with the minus sin t. And we'll get cos t plus cos t will become 2 cos t. Divide by 2, then we get x even, which is the cos t that we know. Cos t is an even function that we got from here. Now, If we talk about the odd component or odd signal, we need to subtract x minus t from the xt. So we will have to subtract this part from xt to x minus t. So this will become minus and this will become plus. So cos t will cancel out from minus cos t, and sin t will add with the other another sin t. So it will become 2 sin t, and we will divide by 2. So the odd component is sin t. So this is the way by which we can identify the even component and odd component of any kind of a signal. Just this is the homework problem, you can try at your home, but I will give you a brief idea about that. That we have already checked sin t is the odd component, cos t is the even component. So similarly, we will have to compute the sin t and cos t. What is this component? Is this even component or odd component? That you can try at your home by substituting t equal to minus t. Then you add xt plus x minus t and divide by 2 to get the even components. And you subtract x minus t from xt and divide by 2 to get the odd components. Okay. Now, if you look another problem, this is a little bit complicated problem. It has four terms, four components, and with some multiplication terms also. So xt is the 1 plus t cos t plus t square sin t plus t cube sin t cos t. So what we can do, we can solve this problem by inspection as well. So what is the inspection property? So just look at that. If we have two components, this because we are using inspection on the product terms only. Here t is multiplied with the cos t, here t square is multiplied with the cos t. So we are using the inspection on the product terms. So the product of two even signals. Let us assume x1t is the even signal. X1t is an even signal and x2t is also an even signal. If we product both of the signals, x1 minus t and x2 minus t, it will become x1t and x2t, because x1t and x2t both are the even components. So we can write x1 minus t equal to x1t and x2 minus t equal to x2t. We can write like this. So product of any two even components will be even signal only. Similarly, if we multiply two odd signals, what will we get in the output? So product of two odd signal will always even signal. Here you can see x1 minus t can be represented by minus of x1t, because x1t is an odd signal. Similarly, x2 minus t can be represented by minus of x2t. So product of two odd signal will be sum of product of two odd signal will be always even signal. Similarly, the product of even signal and odd signal is always odd signal. Here you can see that xc is an even signal and xo is an odd signal. So xc minus t can be represented by xe of t, and xo minus t can be represented by minus of xot. So we are getting here minus xct xot. So this overall, due to the minus sign, it is representing this is an odd signal. Okay, now we'll apply this property on the above signal. Okay, so just keep in mind, product of two even signal will always even, product of two odd signal will always even, and product of one even and odd signal will always odd. Just like that, if we product two positive sign numbers, we always get positive number. If we multiply two negative numbers, we always get positive number. If we multiply one positive and one negative number, we always get the negative number. If negative number is there, we can say that negative means odd and positive means even here. So now we will solve this problem here. In this problem, we have terms 1, t cos t, t square, sin t, t cube, sin t and cos t. Now we will have to identify what all individual terms are there. So one is the even signal. Why one is an even signal? It is not a function of time. So any constant can be represented by, this is the time axis, and this is the one here. Any constant can be represented by an even signal, because it is satisfying the even property, because this one is throughout the time axis from minus infinite to infinite, entire time duration. So here from the origin, from the y-axis, this is satisfying the even property, because the same signal, what signal we have in the first quadrant, that is same in the second quadrant as well. So this is an even signal. T is odd signal, we always know T is an odd signal. If we substitute T equal to minus T, we will get minus T only. T square is also an even signal. If we substitute minus t and take the square, we will get square. So this is an even signal. Okay, TQ, if we substitute minus T and take the Q, it will become minus T of Q. So we are getting minus TQ, that means this is an odd component. And we have already seen cos T is an even signal and sin T is an odd signal. Now come to the next point. If T is an odd signal, cos T is an even signal. If T is an odd signal, cos T is an even signal, what will be the product term? T cos T. We have already seen product of one even and one odd component is always odd component. So here you can see that T cos T is an odd signal. If T square is an even and sin T is an odd signal, what will we get? T square sin T will again odd signal because this is the product of even and odd component. If one we have T cube, which is an odd signal, and sin T we have also odd signal. Let us assume we have written here the product of two odd number will be even. Product of two odd signal will be even. And this cos T is again even. If we multiply even with even, we will get even signal. So overall we will get this term is an even signal. So here T cube sin T is an even, and this is T cube sin T is an even signal, and cos T is again even. So product of two even component will be even. So conclusion is that even components are 1, T cube sin T and T cube sin T cos T. Similarly, odd components are T cos T plus T square sin T. So this is the, here we have solved some problems based on the even and odd components, finding out the even and odd component from the given functions. Thank you for watching this video.